Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, this is the week for weird charting questions. Craig sent in this question yesterday. We had a chart question. Here's another one. I want to point out my book, Charts and Graphs for Excel 2007, has a chapter on how to do all kinds of weird charts like this. Craig has created a chart here, and he's drawn in a line just using the drawing tools that points to a point on the line. And he says, you know, the frustrating thing is when that data changes, for example, make this be 35, the chart redraws, but the arrow is not pointing to the right place anymore. I have to constantly move this arrow to point to the correct spot. Is there some way to get that to automatically happen? Well, yeah, there is, although it's tricky, to be honest. Let's come here. I'm going to change these month names to numbers just to help number the points. Hold down Control while I drag the fill handle. And I'm going to create a secondary series here. I created two sets of formulas. This is going to be an XY series. So we're going to say where the first point is on an X and Y basis. The hard formula here was the one that kind of pointed to the largest item in the series. So I used the max of D3 to D10 to find that 35, and then the match. Find the match of that 35 within D3 to 10 and subtract 1 from it. So that way it's always the arrow is kind of ending a little bit before that point. Now, that's where the arrow ends. The start arrow, I wanted to be 2 less than that, so that way it always kind of has a length of 2. And then for the Y, I decided to go just 1 more than the max, find the max plus 1, and then the start would be about 4 higher than that. Okay, so you can tweak those formulas depending on your data set, how long you want the arrow to be. The really hard part, though, is getting this XY series on the chart. There might be a better way to do it. I always end up going through this whole big long series of steps where I go to select data and say we want to add a new series to the chart. So we add a series, I'm going to call it the XY series, and my series values, you see that it doesn't give me an option to put in both X and Y, it only gives me an option to put in the Y, so I'll delete that, and we start out putting in just the Y values. Click OK. All right, click OK. So we have some data here. It's not an arrow, obviously. Let's fix that first. That's easy to do. We come back to Format and Shape Outline, Arrows, choose the rightward facing arrow. Cool. Let's also go with Weight, make it a little bit thinner, and then Shape Outline, change the color. All right, good enough. Now, just like yesterday's podcast, we're going to go into Format Selection, move that to the secondary axis. Click Close. That allows us to change the chart type of just that one series. So Design, Change Chart Type. We'll come in, XY, there's 5 different XY types here. I want the 5th one, that's no points, straight lines. Although there's only 2 points, it would always be a straight line no matter what. Okay, now just like in yesterday's podcast, we have the problem where the scales are of differing orders of magnitude. So let's fix that. Format axis, and we're going to say that this is fixed going from 0 and up to fixed going to 50. That's the left axis. Now we have to do the exact same thing with the right axis. We can now do that without closing the format dialog box. We can just click on the next thing to format. I want that to be fixed going from 0 and fixed going to 50. Click close. All right, now it's still not working. The arrow seems to be in the wrong spot. What's up with that? We're going to come here to the Layout tab, Layout, under Axes, and look for the secondary horizontal axis. And show default. Right now it's set to none. You see it's set to none. We're going to say show default. Ah, look at that. There's a secondary horizontal axis that they never bothered to show us. And that secondary horizontal axis is going from 0 to 2.5. So let's right click there, format axis, and have it go. I find it works out really good to go from 0 to 8. So that kind of offsets everything off by 1/2. Click close. All right, it's only going from 1 to 2 now. Why is that? Well, remember when we added the data series, we weren't able to specify where the X values were, and so it's just assuming that it goes from 1 to 2. So we'll choose this, go back to Design, go to Select Data, and now edit this, and now because it's an XY chart, we finally get to specify what the series X values are. So they are right there. Click Okay, click OK. All right, so finally we have it. Let's put a little test in here. We'll come up with some other value that's even larger. So we'll put 40 in this spot and move this back to 16. And you see that our arrow redraws. Let's make that a little bit shorter, maybe go down to 30. And sure enough, the arrow continues to move with the item. Now, a couple of things here. We really don't need this axis at the top. We can go back to layout, axes, secondary, none. That'll get rid of it. And also, let's see, axes, secondary, vertical, none. Don't display it. There we go. Now we have our chart. Finally, we really could have left this being the months all the way along. It just helps me to count how many points there were. We go back to Craig's original chart. But as we change the numbers, the chart changes. Pretty cool. Let's go with 35 here. And the chart arrow redraws. There you have it. Pretty obscure. I'm sure Craig was looking for something really simple. Unfortunately, it's not simple, but it is possible to get it set up. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.